A seemingly straightforward process, flight diversions are a complex interplay of various factors. Landing at the closest airport during a diversion might seem to be the best option, but numerous practical considerations often lead to a different outcome. Today, let's learn about some factors that play a role in determining if the closest airport is indeed the best airport to divert to. Let's first examine emergency diversions. These follow checklists or the captain's authority. Phrases like "land at the nearest suitable airport" or "land as soon as possible" guide these decisions. Medical emergency diversions require authorization from airline telemedicine doctors, usually under critical circumstances. Contrary to popular belief, only airline employee telemedical service doctors, dispatchers, or pilots can authorize diversions. Traveling doctors assist, but aren't the authorities. During medical emergencies, the choice of the airport to divert to depends upon whether the required medical facilities are available at or near the airport. If the situation of the patient is dire, diverting to the nearest airport, which might have only basic medical facilities, can be a good option. If the patient has a more stable condition, the crew, in coordination with medical staff, can determine the best airport for the patient. For technical diversions, once an immediate landing is ruled out, flight crew assess the situation to determine the best diversion airport. The amount of fuel on board is, of course, a major factor. In addition to this, if an aircraft suffers a technical problem, the crew will choose to divert to airports with proper maintenance staff and facilities. Further, the airline will consider if the airport has scheduled available flights for passengers. Inclement weather at the destination can also lead to diversions. In a country like Nepal, where many airports are located in the mountainous regions, pockets of clouds can develop quite quickly over a region, making a landing unsafe at certain facilities. Stormy and/or windy conditions may also prompt diversions to alternate airports. When the decision to divert is made, the flight crew notifies ATC. The crew provides essential details such as the reason for diversion, the estimated time of arrival at the new airport, and any special requirements like medical emergencies. Then, a new flight plan is made. The availability of runway and emergency service readiness are checked beforehand. Eventually, clearances and approaches are made. When an aircraft diverts, passengers experience various scenarios depending on the situation. For minor disruptions, such as temporary weather issues or basic technical problems, the flight may continue to its original destination after a short delay. The aircraft lands at the nearest suitable airport in more extreme emergencies when there is a threat to safety or a severe medical issue. Passengers are then transferred to the next available flight to reach their final destination. Airlines do their best to plan diversions to airports where they have a presence or can find services providing convenience for the passengers. Sometimes, unprepared airports pose challenges, such as lack of ground service equipment or customs facilities. Regardless of the cause, airlines must get passengers to their final destination at no extra cost. Therefore, the airlines select the airport accordingly. In summary, pilots in coordination with airlines choose the best outcome, considering every possible aspect. When flights divert for multiple reasons, the decision isn't always to land at the nearest airport. Airlines strive to harmonize technical requirements with passenger service to optimize safety and minimize disarray. So, have you ever been on a diverted flight? Share your experiences by commenting below. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.